Hey everybody, it's Congressman Scott Peters coming to you from In Place, where I think we should stay. We've been hearing a lot this week about the payroll protection program, the loan program that we passed in the CARES Act with $350 billion to try to keep people on the payroll. It's run out of money. So we're gonna have to put more money in it. There's no disagreement about that. Looks like today there's a deal between the Republicans and the Democrats. And we're going to adopt it, put more money in the program so that these businesses have the money they need to keep people on the payroll. I got to tell you, one problem with it, though, is that it means that a bunch of us are going to have to get on planes and fly to Washington, D.C. when our governor has made an order that we're supposed to stay at home. So I'm struggling with whether to go. What's the right thing to do? Amazingly, after 9/11, Congress does not have a procedure yet for remote voting. And you would have thought that after that event, they would have anticipated a time when we really shouldn't be traveling or couldn't be traveling. That this is one of those times. I think that makes us look in Congress like we're out of touch. If the rules don't apply to us, that makes us look arrogant. And frankly, there's a lot of people out there who are saying that's not that big a deal. We think it is a big deal. We shouldn't be playing into this notion that getting on the plane is no big deal. So I'll go on the plane if I have to, if they need my vote. But when I get there, I'm going to fight to see if we can't adopt a remote voting procedure for emergency times like this so that we can practice what we preach, we can stay home, we can be safe, and we're not flying back and forth between hotspots like Washington, D.C., frankly. So we'll keep you posted and hang in there. We'll get through this.